So unfortunately, we're not quite ready to be all smiley. Sebastian tells me it's going to be a few years before I can get my own self-driving car. But the bigger problem is we haven't yet talked about how to actually use a procedure. All we've done is make them. Until we can actually use them, we don't have a good reason to be really happy yet. But we're going to learn how to use them next, and then we'll be back to being smiling. So now we're going to learn how to use a procedure. The way to use a procedure, we need the name of the procedure, followed by a left paren, followed by a list of inputs. And there could be any number of inputs, but it has to match the number of inputs the procedure expects. These inputs are sometimes called operands. They're sometimes called arguments. But we're not going to argue about that. We're just going to call them inputs. So you've actually already done something quite similar to this. Back in Unit 1, you learned about using find on strings. And with find, you would pass in one or two inputs. The first input was a string. That was the string that you're looking for. That's the first input. And the second input could be a number, the position where you start looking for that string. And so we use find in many ways in Unit 1, as well as you used it yourself in the homework for Unit 1. Find is a little different from the procedures that you define yourself. First of all, it's built in. The other thing that was different is that instead of just having find, we had another input that was really over here, right? We had the string that we're doing the find in. Let's say it was in the variable page. That's really another input to find. We'll talk in a later class about why that's done differently. But it's very similar to calling a procedure where one of the inputs is over here, the other two are here. It's a little different from that, and we won't get into that in this course, but in a later course, you'll learn more about what this really means. For all the procedures that you define yourself, we won't have any object to invoke them on. We'll just have the procedure to call and the arguments or operands or inputs, as you like to call them, to pass in. So let's see how that works with a simple procedure. I'm going to define the procedure rest of string, and we'll give it the parameter s. So that means it takes one input, and we're going to use the name s to refer to the value of that input. And we'll make it return the string from the first character to the end. So we'll use the string indexing operator, return s one colon. This will evaluate to the string with the first letter removed. So all strings from the position one until the end of the string. And that's what we return. So that's the output of rest of string, is that new string that starts from the second letter in the input string. Here's an example of how to use this procedure. So we could call it directly. So we could say print rest of string. So that's our procedure. Now we're going to have our paren, and we're going to pass in an input. There's one parameter to rest of string, so we need one input to pass in, and it should be a string. So we'll pass in the string audacity. What happens when we call a procedure like this? Execution will jump into the body of the procedure. So we can think of what the interpreter is doing is now, instead of running the code here, the interpreter will move. When we call a procedure, it will jump to run the code inside the procedure. It will assign to the parameters the values passed in as the inputs. So we can think of this as there being an assignment that says now the value of s is the value of this input that was passed in. And now we're going to evaluate the body of the procedure. In this case, there's only one statement. It's this return statement. We're going to find this value. So s index one colon. The result of that is going to be the string udacity. And then we got to the return. What return means is we're going to jump back. We're jumping back to where we called the procedure. But now we actually have a result. So when we jump back, the value that this evaluates to is whatever value we returned. In this case, it's the string udacity. So we don't have our self-driving car, but now you can define and use procedures. This is a really powerful concept. Anything that we're going to do in the rest of the course, and anything almost anyone does in programming computers, is all about defining procedures and using procedures. So now we should have a big smile. We can think of our procedures in terms of mapping inputs to outputs. We can think of our humans as also mapping inputs to outputs. We have inputs coming in through the eyes, through the mouth. Maybe we even have a nose. And I won't try to draw any of the outputs of our human procedure. But since procedures are such an important concept, we're going to have several quizzes now to check that you understand them well.